Hello friends, in this video we are going to see VI characteristic of a ideal current source. So I am taking a current source of the value I ampere, so like this. To this current source I am connecting a load resistor RL. Now the circuit is closed, current will flow through this RL, which will be IL. Since current is flowing through the RL, I will get voltage across it of this polarity. So I can say voltage VL is IL into RL. Now we are going to draw VI characteristic of this ideal current source. This time independent variable is VL, and depend on value of VL I will have values of IL. Now let's take a simple example. Let's take this current source is of 5 ampere. Since for this IL the only source is this I, every time I can say IL will be a 5 ampere. So I will consider IL as a 5 ampere, same as the value of I. And based on the value of RL and using this equation I will get VL. So in first case let's take RL is 1 ohm, so the VL will become 5 volt. Again for a second observation, IL will remain 5, resistor value if I am considering 10, I will get VL as 50. One more value we will take for RL 100, since I and IL are same 5, so that VL I will get 500 volt. So no matter what are the value of VL, I will get IL same, which is nothing but I, value is 5 ampere. So if I draw the graph of IL and VL, I will get a straight line like this. Irrespective of any value of VL, I will get fixed IL decided by I. So here we have seen that whenever current source is given, no matter what are the elements connected in series to that current source, we should not bother about a current flowing through that particular element, because that current will be fixed and given by current source value. Thank you.